I was actually gonna spell goat, so whatever. Is goals.
Mm-hmm.
Are goals important to us?
Yes.
Yes.
Yep.
Alright, so what does the G mean? Or what does the G stand for?
GCI.
Goals. GCI? Goals? No. It's actually. Oh gosh. Grateful. Alright, so. The ALC, who reads the ALC minutes? Just real quick, raise your hand. Alright, so one of the things that we talked about pretty heavily in ALC is gratitude and how important it is. Alright, so what is the highest form of energy?
Gratitude.
Gratitude. So if we were able to practice gratitude every single day, would we be setting up our personal and professional life at the highest level?
Yes.
If we practice gratitude every single day. To be thankful for you guys, to be thankful for just everything in life is super important. And is there a lot of tragedy going on right now?
Yes.
So to be thankful in a moment when there's a lot of tragedy is going to set you apart. And it's going to bring a lot of energy back into your life. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So I challenge you guys today to really look at everything that comes along your way and be grateful for it. You know why? Because gratefulness will turn in, oh my gosh, let's see what I can do this. Obstacle, being grateful for something, as soon as you see an obstacle coming, come at you, being grateful for that moment, you know what you can find?
Opportunity.
Opportunity. Kind of reminds me of that one Bold Law. Change the way you look at things.
The things we look at will change.
You look at change. If you're grateful for an obstacle that comes in your way, I guarantee you, in that moment, it would turn into an opportunity. You have to change the way you look at things, and that thing you're looking at will change. Be grateful for it, I guarantee you opportunity will show up. And since we're being grateful, I would like to take a second and be very grateful for our admin. Let's just give them a round of applause. Without our admin, we would be dead. Who agrees with me? Raise your hand.
Yes.
Right dead.
We would be on the ground shaking. You guys are the glue to our business. We love admin. So I just wanted to take an opportunity to be very thankful. There's no way I can do Valerie's job. Not even for a second. And she loves it. And she keeps this thing rolling. So being very thankful for the ones that you do surround yourself with and admin. Okay? Does that make sense?
Yes.
Who can take a guess at what the L is?
Leverage.
Leverage.
Leverage is a good one. However, it's not this one. However, it can be used as leverage.
Leadership.
Listings.
Listings. That's right. So I think this is pretty cool because give yourself a hand because all of you guys fell off the board. Give yourself a hand. We've been pushing listings pretty hard, so for everyone who's new, falling off the board, we have a listing board in the hallway. And when we fall off of it, means our company has taken so many listings, we've literally fallen off the board.
And we double-space them.
And we double-space the lines. So we have to tape a piece of paper to it and add more listings. So you guys fell off the board. Why did we push listings last month? Why?
Christmas.
That's right. So the Christmas time worked. Good. Yes, because Christmas time. We will not fall into the category that it is a seasonal slowdown. We won't allow that to happen. Correct? The season doesn't tell us how we can control our business, does it?
Correct.
No, we control our business and we do it with listings. And you guys listened, you showed up, and we fell off the board. Huge congratulations. Thank you so much. So don't forget about listings. And what month is it?
October.
So what is 90 days from now?
2018.
2018, guys. Hmm? Oh, husband comes home. 2018 is excellent. More chores he's going to do? So whatever we do right now will show up 90 days from now. So literally, we're standing in 2018. So if you guys show up pushing hard on listings now, you've literally set up 2018 to be absolutely amazing. You've already done it at Christmas. You just watch. So focus on
listings.
I'm gonna give you some stats real quick. When someone asks you how's the market, when it talks to listings taken, what do you tell them?
Great. Why do you ask?
Why do you ask? Hey, looking to sell a home. So right now, if you look at the lore, everyone know what the lore is?
Yes.
We're actually, the lore, did I hear no? Okay, so no. So someone want to explain to the real, explain to her real quick what the lore is?
Language of real estate.
Yep, and what does it show us?
Shows us how Keller Williams is outpacing the market.
Sounds amazing, doesn't it? And now you're a part of that. So it's pretty cool. So actually, the board is down 10%. If I read that correctly. Yep. The board is down 10% on listings taken right now. And we are up how much? Rounding points, whoever gets it.
15.
No.
7.2.
We've got C in you. I don't know. 9%. We're up 9%, so we're actually outpacing the market by 19% right now. So give yourself a hand. Excellent job, y'all. Excellent job. So we're going to come back to sales. So sales equals what?
Money,
GCI, right? Right?
Right,
okay. All right. Does anybody know what the cost of living is? Or inflation, I apologize. What inflation is every single year? 3%. Close to 3%. So if we're making a 3% return on our real estate business, are we getting ahead of the game? Are we?
Yes.
No.
I didn't hit
it. Not. Inflation is actually eating up our money, correct?
Right.
So I go back and I look at the sales, and by the way, if we focus on listing, it's going to bring in more sales. I look at the sales and I say, okay, so how ahead are we as a market center in GCI? How much do you think we're up in GCI, this market center? Oh, year to date. Did I lose you guys when I started talking about numbers?
Yes.
Numbers are important, guys. They tell the story. So if we know inflation is going up 3%, we are actually up 11% in this office right now. Give yourself a hand. So not only are we outpacing the market, we're outpacing inflation right now. Having an 11% return on this investment being real estate is huge. So I wanted to give you a huge, huge, huge up on this. Here's another thing. Contracts written. What does contracts written mean in our business?
Agency, right?
Oh, well, let me word it.
Yeah. Contracts and closings.
Yes, pending. So if we write a contract and now it's under contract and we can scale that in our business, what does that mean for us? It means it's future business, correct? Some of that probably didn't close right now. It's still pending as future business. And if we know that we usually run about 90-day course. When are we going to be closing these contracts that we're writing? 2018. So I go back and I look at the numbers and I say, well, okay, so how up are we right now year to date in contracts written? We're up 28%
wow.
In contracts written. That's future business for 2018 up 30%. Give yourself a hand. So it was super important to cover those numbers because yes, y'all did a fantastic job last month to roll us over into Christmas, one of the best times of the year, and we set up our business to give us some money during Christmas. The cool thing is, right now, we're setting up our business to be super successful in the beginning of 2018. So, what I'd like for you to think now in October is think 2018 by being grateful for what you have right now. Okay? And every time you run into an obstacle, be grateful for it. I guarantee you it'll show up an opportunity to show up. Always thank our admin. That is just a big bonus. Always thank your admin. Focus on listings. It's obviously working. 2018, focus on listings now to set up 2018 to be an amazing, amazing year. And if we do so, our sales will bring in more money, which right now we're up 11%. We're touching 30% with contracts written, or with contracts written, that 2018 is going to be absolutely amazing. So, thank you for everything you guys do because you're listening and you're actually putting it into action and the numbers are showing it. So I want to be grateful for all of you for everything you guys do, and I'm excited to see 2018. Thank you so much.